We're in a tough moment here. One where the market's just beginning to wake up to the hideous reality that we're now hostage to Colonel Gaddafi and the Middle Eastern dominoes. Do not get too depressed, though, because the moment we truly get rid of Gaddafi, I could see the Dow rally as much as 1,000 points. Just don't know what level it's going to happen from. Why do we care so much about one little tin pot dictator in a country that's not even one of the top 10 producers of oil? Simple. Until the tensions in North Africa get resolved, there's a strong possibility that oil prices keep soaring, maybe even back to where they peaked in the great short squeeze of 2008. That's $147. Wait, it happened once before. Nothing's changed. If that happens pretty soon, the raising estimates gain that we've had after almost every quarter, except for Sienna's today, and the cutting estimates gain will have arrived. In other words, we're not going to be boosting numbers, we're going to be cutting numbers. And given that the single most important determinant of overall price performance for stocks is whether the companies they represent beat or fail to beat the estimates, if you take that away and nothing else from the show, you've got it, then you can understand how it might make sense for everything to fall right now, except for a very few handful of companies that are totally immune to the ups and downs of the economy. But do not despair. The good news is that we've seen this all before, or at least I have, since I'm an old guy. I was trading all the way back in 1990 when Iraq invaded Kuwait. I was trading in 1982, but that market was awful. The pattern we saw today is exactly what happened in the fall of 1990. This morning at the opening, we rallied on rumors that Gaddafi was going to head out of town. Of course, we didn't realize that instantly. It wasn't until 10 o'clock that we realized why we were rallying. And by that time, we realized the rationale was bogus. So everybody who came in at the opening and bought was a loser. So then the market got hit real bad midday. Everybody coughed up the stock that they bought because they thought Gaddafi was gone. And then we rallied in the afternoon, maybe because people didn't want to go home short or betting against the market. It wasn't enough to get back to even. That's the new pattern, okay? And we're going to play this game endlessly until killer Gaddafi leaves town. That's just what we did in 1990. We would rally on every rumor that Saddam Hussein was going to pull out of Kuwait, or that peace was going to break out, or that the Secretary of State was meeting with the guy who was running the country. I mean, an internal revolt in Iraq. Every rumor, the market went up. And every time, the market would get crushed when those rumors turned out not to be true. The right move wasn't to buy the rumor, but to sell it or short every one of these rallies. And you know what? Playbook is exactly the same now. We got to presume that Gaddafi's no different from Saddam, which means he's not going to leave Libya without some military might standing up to him. I think that means all rumors will be false rumors until you see NATO move against the guy. How do we break this pattern? We need to see the market go down and stay down, not rally at the end of the day. And then we need good news in the form of, one, NATO action against Gaddafi, two, U.S. government selling the oil futures, preferably the July contract, more on that later, knowing that it's got all the oil it needs to be able to sell futures in the Strategic Petroleum Reserve. And three, the kings of Bahrain and Saudi Arabia, they need to be told they aren't going to be buried under the pyramids like Mubarak in Egypt. They are not going to be part of the cornerstone of the next new stadium built in the Middle East. I don't think this plan's a pipe dream. If Libya's resolved in a Ronald Reagan way, meaning that we bomb the guy, except for this time we hit him, and if we tell the rulers of Saudi Arabia and Bahrain that they're our buddies, our pals, and our friends, and our government sells oil futures out to July against the Strategic Petroleum Reserve, then this market will go through the roof. My plan is both logical and doable. The only thing it requires is some presidential horse sense. Can we bet on it? I honestly don't know. But I also want to paint too bearish a picture, because while it was foolish to chase the rallies in 1990, you know what was even more foolish? To leave the table. As we eventually rallied and rallied hard when the U.S. came to the rescue, you just couldn't trade the market to any satisfaction when it was up. Because if you chased, you ended up with hummus all over your face. That's why I can't get too negative here. And it makes sense to hang on and stay in the game. Here's the bottom line. We don't want to go home too long, meaning own too much stock. Maybe Gaddafi bombs the oil fields. Or maybe the U.S. makes some castigating remark about Arab monarchies. But we don't want to go home too short either. Because if the government sells oil futures and says the kings of Bahrain and Saudi Arabia are better than King George VI, if not Colin Firth himself, and NATO says enough of Gaddafi, this market will rip 1,000 points higher. And oil will drop 10 bucks in the blink of an eye. So, conclusion. Stay cautious. But don't get too negative.